Hello there and welcome to my channel. I recently bought a second-hand Honma TW747V iron set. I found them on the local Dutch eBay-like website. Now they were 3 months old, came at a bargain price with shafts that are absolutely perfect for me, so I had to pull the trigger. Now these Honmas are cavity back players irons, and my 10-11 handicap might be a tad too high for them. To find out, I will compare them to my TaylorMade P770s that are currently in my bag. So we have a battle of the smaller cavity back players irons against the slightly bigger hollow body players irons. Let's do this. Alright, so here are the Honma TW747Vs. They are great looking irons. They are smaller than the P770s and they have a smaller top line. Let me try and show this to you guys. Now the lofts are very similar because I have bent my P770s 1 degree stronger to blend with my P794 iron, and I bent the Honma pitching wedge, which Honma calls the 10, 1 degree stronger to 45 degrees. And basically all lofts in this test are equal. Now the offset on the cavity back Honmas is a little bit less than the P770s, exactly as you would expect from a player's iron. Both irons have stiff shafts. The Honma has got the Nippon Modus Tour 105 and the TaylorMade has got the KBS Tour 105. Now I would expect that the Honmas sound less clicky than the TaylorMades that are hollow and packed with technology. And I wouldn't be surprised if the ball flight on the Honmas will be lower with slightly higher spin due to the lower center of gravity. And since the P770s are packed with tech, they might go further. But let's just see. I will be using Titleist Pro V1 golf balls. I'll hit some shots on the Foresight Sports GC2 with HMT launch monitor. I'll collect the data and show you the results afterwards. Okay, so let's start with the Honma pitching wedge. Go in, spin. Okay, TaylorMade pitching wedge. All right, Honma 6-iron. Oh, turned it over a little bit. Yeah, so these Honmas definitely sound less clicky and they feel very, very soft. Very nice. Get in. Oh. All right, so let's take a look at the numbers. Now, in general, I would say that on both irons, the launch angles are too high, and that is probably a result of my attack angle that is way too high. I normally am 2 degrees down on my 6-iron, 3 degrees down on my 8-iron, and 6 degrees down on my pitching wedge. And these angle of attacks are way too shallow. Now I'm going through some swing changes with my PGA Teaching Pro, so I need to sort that out. Having said that, there's really not much between these irons. Club speed, ball speed, carry, smash factor, all very similar. The only difference is that the ball is getting there slightly different. The Honmas are launching lower, have a lower height and a higher spin. So basically the Honmas have a bit more penetrating ball flight. And if you look at dispersion, it seems that dispersion is tighter on the TaylorMade P770s, especially with the 6-iron. Okay, so what does this all come down to? Well, the Honmas, they look better, they are smaller, got a thinner top line, less offset, the sound is better, and the feel is much softer. The TaylorMades are a bit more clickier, as you might expect from a more techy iron. Now, the pros of the TaylorMades is they have a little bit more forgiveness and better dispersion, especially on the longer irons. Okay, now this is me hitting balls from an indoor mat. Outdoors could be very different since the Honmas have a slimmer sole. So I'll need to take the Honmas outside, and if they perform outside as good as they perform inside, there's a good chance I'm putting them into my bag. That's it for now, and this 10 handicap hacker comparison between a cavity bag player's iron and a hollow body constructed player's iron. I hope you enjoyed it. Keep safe and see you next time. Bye bye. Thank you.